James Bond's a degenerate. He doesn't drive a Ford.
I'm guessing that any feelings of claustrophobia had to be knocked out of you for this film.
You mean with the cars? Yeah, they're not built for comfort and there isn't a lot of space.
It looked like you could barely move a finger in there.
It's very true, yeah. No, you have to remove the steering wheel in order to get in, yeah.
So the film focuses on one of the most important moments of Ken and Shelby's careers. If someone were to make a film about either of you, what would be that big moment?
Someone else has to decide that, don't they? Yeah. It's definitely not for the actual subjects to decide. We've talked about that a lot.
It's like, imagine if somebody said, I'm going to make a film of your life and I'm going to boil it down into 2 hours. It's like, it's very hard to do that. That's why these are kind of snapshots of these men. You try to build a three-dimensional person, but this is only one little moment in their lives, really. Because there's so much that you could focus on when doing a story about.
But this is this moment of a crescendo with their combined obsession, their dreams, their cantankerousness, their stubbornness, their friendship driving them to this point of brilliance, where it was a perfect storm that happened that created these legends within the racing world.
And there's a line in this film which made me laugh so much, which is James Bond's a degenerate, he doesn't drive a Ford. Right. If James Bond were to go head to head in a race with Ken, who do you think would win?
Ken would win. Of course, Ken he would. James Bond. I'm sure he drives very well, but he doesn't have that same thing that Ken Miles has. That's all he lives for. You know.
I love the way
that
Tracy Letts delivers that line too. James Bond's a degenerate. He doesn't drive a Ford. Yeah,
but
Ken
raced against James Dean. You know, and then obviously Steve McQueen was a very good driver as well. But Ken actually, he won very easily against James Dean, but he was a very good driver, James Dean. He came in third, and then Ken got disqualified. I can't remember why. He was always doing something naughty that the officials said, no, you're out. And one time he was so far in the lead, he stopped, he jumped out, he got a sandwich, he ate his sandwich, he got back in the car, and then he went and won the race. And things like that tend to rub officials the wrong way. You know, he was a real individual, a real personality. He actually drove against a lot of celebrities.
Well, I was actually going to say that Ken's described in the film as being difficult but good. How do you think your friends and family would best describe you both?
Not bad. That's probably quite on it, really. I hope there's the but good.
Yeah.
In there as well. I do hope so. Yes.
I wouldn't describe you as difficult, though. I would never use that word. I thought it was pleasurable to work with. I mean, just like very generous.
Well, it's great when you get someone and like they have where it's cooperation that makes a great film.
Yeah,
you know.
Totally.
Of course, you're going to have conflict, but it's a cooperative conflict. It's a conflict that knows, hey, we're both looking out for the same thing, you know? And actually, we didn't have any bloody conflict at all, did we? It was, he's a bloody great actor and never tries stepping on anyone's toes. You know, lets me do my thing. I want him to do his thing. And that works out bloody great. This was such a fun film to make.
And what's the kind of the best quality you found in each other then?
I think his generousness in that respect.
I'd say the same about him.
No, I'm a bit of a bromance going on.
Making me blush.
No, but it's also just the dedication to the thing. Like I saw Bono interviewed once, and he was talking about that. He said when a song walks into the room, he goes in the way in our hierarchical system. He was talking about his band. He said the musician is low, the song is high.
Yeah.
You know, and it's all about checking your own ego and all your stuff at the door and working in service of the thing that you're making together. Right. And there's never any, I never felt anything other than Christian was totally there to make everybody better so that the thing could be better. You know what I mean? And it's fun to work. I feel like it was a like-minded group, and Jim surrounds himself with people that he's worked with before. So there's a lot of bickering that's playful, but
bloody hilarious.
It's funny, yeah. It's all about making the thing better. So everyone's making suggestions, and if you suggest 50 things and one of the suggestions is taken, then you've contributed, and it doesn't matter that 49 of the things were a no. You know what I mean? It's your job to try to improve.
I was going to ask about the fight scene. Did you realize that bread could be so handy?
We love that moment because it's like two brothers fighting. He doesn't want to hurt him. You know, they don't actually want to hurt each other. They want to give each other a good smack, but he goes for the can and he's like, oh, no, that's going to hurt. I'll get him with the bread.